referees are Jake Brink and Dean Morton. The linesmen are Vaughn Rohde and Travis Garlitz. We're underway. The opening faceoff brought to you by Simpson Chevrolet. St. Louis had their Thursday game postponed at Vegas due to an abundance of caution because of COVID, and Gibson has to make a save. Boy, that was strange-looking play. The rebound pops to Kyrou, who pots it, and just 20 seconds in, it's 1-0.
They just snap it right on the net, and Gibson's caught out of position. Now there's a big rebound, and boy, pulling it right into his wheelhouse and just snapping it up top to Jordan Kyrou. And we've talked, you know, when you talk to people about the St. Louis Blues and ask them who's the most improved player on your team, they're going to all say this.
Ducks try to move it up the boards but fail to get it out of their own zone. Lindholm giving a rough ride in the corner. Curtis Sanford walks right in front, tries to stuff it. Got his own rebound and scored. 57 seconds in, it's 2-0 St. Louis.
Well, they just walk right out of the corner and stuff a rebound behind Gibson. Looking around like thinking to himself, what the heck just happened? But Kevin Shattenkirk does not play that particularly well. He just allows Sanford to bring it right into the crease area and then puts no pressure on him as he collects the rebound and throws it up and under the bar. The Ducks are being out-muscled.
Jimmy Blais swats it out, and here's Mike Hoffman. Hoffman dumps it in, bounces right back to the slot and gets his own rebound there and fires it off of Gibson and out of play. A couple years removed from an 11-goal season, he's not just a physical presence, he can score. And here's Shen headmanning. It's Kyrou again, and he's got another one. 3-0 Blues. Well,
the floodgates are just opening up. And, boy, John Gibson is making his way over to the Anaheim bench, and I think that might be it for him. Starts with Binnington just rimming it around. It gets in behind Shattenkirk, and the pass here just threads the needle. Kyrou's in behind Adam Henrique. He's alone on the breakaway. And watch him pick his target. Where does he go? Just under the glove, over the left leg pad. And it's a 3-0 St. Louis lead in the rest of this period, because this requires a significant response. And whether you, oh my.
Oh, off of Miller and just wide of the near post as Perron threw it to the net. Lundis from being leaned on by Barbashev. Now picked up by Torrey Krug, who jams at it. It comes back to Lindholm. Slides it across. Shattenkirk into the middle of the ice. And the shot from Jones got through. A pad save by Binnington.
That was a good quick shot by Max Jones.
Justin Falk on his backhand sends it back. Krug with that short little pass sends Sammy Blais away. On the right side, speeding into the zone is Falk. All the way to the bottom of the circle. Miller with a point blank save.
Big part of the reason why they were eliminated so early on in that tournament.
And so many chances now for Perron, but Miller, as he didn't have any options, came out, cut the angle, and makes the stop. We'll say this, he looks confident with the puck in the early going, carrying it through the neutral zone on a couple of occasions, making moves and creating space. Right in front, a point blank save by Miller on Kyrou, who very nearly had the hat trick.
Moment in this hockey game. The Ducks caught both defensemen and the center. And again, Kyrou looked like he was trying to go five-hole, much like David Perron.
There's a turnover. Jones banging away, and he scores! Getzloff just threw it to the blue paint. Jones was there. Nobody cleared him out. He had a couple cracks at it, and Anaheim's on the board.
How often have we seen this where a goaltender makes an incredible stop? Kyrou on the doorstep all alone. But then it's Parayko that turns it over. Getzloff throws it in. Binnington makes a couple of stops. But both Raquel and Jones keep hacking away at it. And eventually it's
As Comtois had it blocked back to the corner. Now he battles with Sundquist there. Steele is in to win the puck. Sam Steele, nice pass across. Heinen hit the post. The penalty over to Dunn as the second period underway, and Jones, who has the Anaheim goal, speeds in right down the slot, swatting at it as it was left there, was Getzloff, and it's held by Binnington.
Puck's got to go out. It's not good enough just to do a little flip towards the blue line. Your team's under pressure.
And here's Falk activating, and a glove save by Ryan Miller, who came firing out in a little left-handed larceny. Colton Parayko, the former Alaska Anchorage Seawolf, back to play it. ahead to Sanford, who pokes it across the line, sets up a two-on-one. Miller again comes flying out to make the save. Steal with some help from Silverberg, able to clear the line. Kyrou gets it out of his feet, brings it back across the line into the middle, and Schwartz with a shot. Got his own rebound, hit the side of the net. Miller covers as Schwartz rolls it back into the goal crease. As the Blues lead 3-1, Zach Sanford, who has the other St. Louis goal, has the puck in the Anaheim zone along with David Perron. Perron on the backhand, hoists it in behind the net, trying to settle it with Lindholm, but he was under duress and loses it to O'Reilly. Into the slot, and Perron scores! David Perron in one motion. It's 4-1.
Just love to shoot the puck. It's a giveaway from Lindholm this time. Watch this pass. Little saucer pass. That may have touched the leg of Ryan Getzlaf on the way to the net. We'll get a good look from that. Yeah, I think it hits the glove of Getzlaf. Changes direction. And it's off the post and in.
Excuse me, it was Dunn who was up on the play. It was handled by Miller. Now tipped to center. Here's Comtois. Partial break. Can he get away from Parayko? He does. He goes backhand. Oh, did Binnington get a piece of that? Or did he hit the side of the net? He looked like he had him beaten.
Backus gets the puck, throws it up the middle, and a nice play by Comtois creates a breakaway for himself. Does a great job shielding the puck from Colton Parayko, but then the toe of the skate of Jordan Binnington just gets a little piece, or is it actually Comtois' stick? It's hard to tell.
I think it hits his pad
from
first.
From that angle.
And that goes rink wide, and that got away from Sanford. Lindholm pounced on that and headmans for Steele. Steele got it over to Silverberg. Silverberg pulls it in, save Binnington. Man pass intended for Robert Thomas. I'm not sure why that wasn't icing, unless they're ruling he touched it. So they play on. Heinen through center. Across the line has Comtois. Quick trigger rebound for Heinen there. Still loose in front of Binnington. Up and down we go. Comtois pressured by Parayko. Parayko heads to the front of the net. Didn't get much on his backhand, or Miller kicked it out.
And you're just hoping that somehow you're going to be able to get some kind of a whistle.
And Binnington makes a more difficult save off the faceoff there. And now Henrique brings it back into the zone. Adam Henrique peels off the boards, trying to find a late coming Heinen, but it's deflected away. And Sundqvist the other way for the Blues. He's hooked down and they score! There was a delayed penalty coming up, but Kyle Clifford took the pass and beat Miller to the stick side. It's 5-1.
And, you know, this is all about the release for Kyle Clifford, who pots his second goal of the season. And watch how Clifford accepts this pass. Right away, shoots it immediately. We'll see if this touches the stick of Ben Hutton here. It might have been slightly...
Backus intercepts, trying to kick it loose. Under a minute to go on the power play. Trickles to the line, kept alive there by Krug. Perron pulls it in. Miller makes the save. Can't corral the rebound. Thomas had a crack at it. Miller stopped that as well. Miller lost his stick. He's got it back now as Dunn works it to the right side. Vince Dunn, middle of the ice. Throws a wrist shot and scores! The Blues convert on the power play. It's 6-1.
Well, this is just a real smart shot by Dunn. Look at the two players. You have both Thomas in front of the net and Sanford in front of the net. And they're both screening. And there's not a chance that Ryan Miller is going to be able to see this. Look at that traffic. And so you might have... And the reason why it comes outside is that the Ducks encroached and all came down after the whistle. You can't do that, or the faceoff comes outside the blue line. So, you know, this game, this was all decided the opening moments of this one. Anaheim was not ready to go.